So anybody who rides dirt bikes will tell you that this is one of the most fun sports you can get into, but with the high cost to entry, it kicks out 99% of the people who would be interested in trying it out. That is where this bad boy comes in. This here is an Apollo RFZ. This is a 2020 125cc pit bike that you can get online directly shipped to your door. Now there are a bunch of similar 125cc pit bikes like this from other brands, but there are no Japanese dirt bikes built quite like this. With a tall suspension and a small frame suited for adult riders like me, this bike is awesome for anyone who's looking to get started at a cheap, cheap price compared to any of the other bikes. Pit bikes are something you used to just ride around at the track because you couldn't drive a car or a full-size dirt bike around. So over time, the engines have gotten bigger, the dirt bikes have gotten bigger, and this is kind of where we've ended up, where we now have this mid-sized dirt bike that's a little bit larger than the older conventional size pit bike, but a little bit smaller than your full size dirt bike. As someone who actually takes this bike out and rides it and abuses it on some really hard trails, I've really enjoyed this bike, and I really do think it's a great steal at $1,000 from Amazon shipped to your house. You can take this thing out, get out on the trails, and start ripping for that price. I think it's an absolute steal of a deal, and if it's something that you're looking to get into, this thing is at the entry price point that you could be able to afford to get into it, still able to buy some riding gear and get out, but get some fuel, get some oil in the bike, and take it out and get shredding. So I've now owned this pit bike for coming up on a year now, and here are some of the things that I like about this pit bike. So what's cool is with these pit bikes from Apollo, they do send you a title, so you can go ahead and get this registered, and in some states you can go ahead and make this a street legal dirt bike. So that is a big bonus and something really cool for $1,000. You can get a bike that you can turn into something street legal in some of the states. Something else I really do like about these bikes is that they come with an actual usable skid plate down there. It's actually a decently thick piece of metal that actually holds up to when you're banging this thing out on the rocks and on the trails, and actually protects your engine. I've seen some of the other Chinese pit bikes, they come with this super paper thin little skid plate that's like almost like having cardboard, which is gonna do you no good when you smash it into a rock. You're probably just gonna end up breaking your casing. So having a good skid plate like this bike comes with from factory is a sweet little bonus for a $1,000 dirt bike. Another thing I really do enjoy about this pit bike size is someone like me who's 6'1" can sit comfortably on this, as well as someone who's like 5'4", they can sit comfortably on this, and both people can touch the ground and have ground clearance underneath the bike. So it's a good happy medium between being too low and not enough ground clearance, and too high from the seat and not being able to touch the ground. So it's a perfect blend of having a low seat height with a high ground clearance. Having that low seat height really does inspire confidence in new beginner riders and making them feel confident that they can touch the ground if they go to start falling over. So that's something that's really cool for a beginner rider, is having that lower seat height. Now for a $1,000 dirt bike, you really can't expect everything to be perfect on these dirt bikes, and they do have their own little quirks, but if you're willing to work around them and work on your dirt bike a little bit, these are great starter bikes. So let's go ahead and we're gonna talk over some of the things you need to know if you're gonna go ahead and pick up one of these dirt bikes. Now the first thing I want you guys to be really aware of is that there is two different frame model designs of this dirt bike. So if you guys go ahead and see here, this dirt bike frame is the updated, thicker, stronger design, and it's got these nice thick tube frame, whereas the older style has much more like spaghetti styled frame, which we'll go ahead and throw up on screen here so you guys can see what I'm talking about. But if you guys are going to pick one of these up, make sure you're looking for the updated frame model that has this larger frame tubing. It's just a better overall design, which is stronger, and it's going to last longer when you're taking off those jumps and dumping the bike and crashing it. Now something else to keep in mind is there is different wheel size sets that come with these dirt bikes. So as you guys can see here, we have the larger wheel set, so we have a 17 inch front tire and a 14 inch rear tire. So you can get the smaller optional set as well, which comes with a 14 inch front tire and a 12 inch rear tire, which is more along the pit bike type. But if you want to get something that's a bit more oriented around the trails and getting it out on some rocky, more rough terrain, I definitely advise looking at the big wheel option, as it does a whole lot better in the more technical off-road stuff, as well as the rims are less likely to dent as they're bigger rolling diameter. So that's something I can take into consideration, is looking at a model with the large wheels. So you guys will see listed down in the description where I list the dirt bikes, there are a couple variants, and that is also because there's another type where you can get one with a headlight assembly. So if you're looking to do that street legal version, you might want to look into getting the one that comes with the factory headlight, which is the X19 model, which is sweet. So you don't have to worry about wiring a headlight. It comes with that whole situation already set up for you. So I would look into that if you're looking to get one to make street legal for around $1,000. Now, if you guys are interested in picking up one of these Apollo RFZs, you guys can go ahead down in the description box below. There is links that you guys can go and see if they have them in stock and pick one of these up for yourselves, as well as if you are interested in doing any upgrades or mods to your Apollo. If you already have one, there's a bunch of parts down in the description for you guys to check out. So make sure you guys go down there. And while you're there, you should leave a like and click subscribe and the bell notification so you guys don't miss when we drop some new videos. Now, there is something I would like to mention about these Apollo pit bikes in specific is the shift pattern on them. So with a conventional dirt bike, you would have first at the bottom, neutral would be half a click up and second gear would be a click up from that. On this dirt bike, you have neutral at the bottom and up from there, it's 1, 2, 3, 4. So neutral is at the bottom of the shift, not halfway up like most conventional dirt bikes, which can be nice for a beginner rider. So when you don't have to try and ever struggle and find neutral, you just compress the shifter down, get into neutral and stop the bike. So that is something that's nice for beginner riders is, you know, when you're trying to get used to riding with dirt bike boots, they're a little bit heavier and trying to find that little tiny half click of neutral for beginner riders can be difficult. So it's nice with this shift pattern that you can just go ahead, hit it down a bunch of times and you're into neutral. Now, something else I really do like about these Apollo dirt bikes is that they come situated with OEM factory disc brakes, both front and rear. So that's something you're not gonna get if you're looking at any Japanese brand bikes that are in this like pit bike kind of category. Pretty much all of them come with drum brakes, which as you guys know, drum brakes are kind of ancient in history and they kind of suck, especially if they get wet. Once a drum brake gets wet, they're pretty well useless. So if you want to get out and ride all seasons, all year long, disc brakes are by far the way to go. They're just way better stopping power and they work much, much better in the wet. And if you guys are interested, you can go ahead and buy some disc brake guards for your rotors so you guys don't damage them when you guys hit some rocks. So there is those products available and there is a plethora of upgrades you guys can do to this dirt bike. For example, here is my Apollo dirt bike that I have customized. I have custom graphics on it. Done a 150cc engine swap. And if you guys are curious, there is a playlist up that in the corner that you guys can check out and see how I built this dirt bike. I've done the big wheel swap on this and it's really made it its own dirt bike. Now, if you guys are curious in any of the parts listed for the upgrades and modifying your RFZ, once again, they are in the description of this video. So you guys can go down there and check them out. Now, if you guys are considering picking up one of these dirt bikes, I will say to consider picking up some extra tools while you're there because you will be working on these dirt bikes. They do need a little bit of extra love compared to a conventional Japanese dirt bike, which is kind of to be expected with these bikes. You know, you're paying $1,000 for one of these. It's relatively cheap and inexpensive. If you're there, you might as well go ahead and pick up some tools if you don't have some, because you're gonna need some when you go to work on this dirt bike. So if you guys need some tools, those are also listed down below. Easy to find for you guys exactly what you need to work on one of these dirt bikes. Now, keep in mind when you do receive this dirt bike, if you end up buying one, when it comes in shipping, it's gonna come with the front end disassembled. And if you guys wanna check a video out where I built mine, you guys can go here and check that out. It's gonna come with the front forks disassembled. So you're gonna have to put those together and put the front wheel on, which is just relatively simple stuff. Put the handlebars on, the accessories on them. So this is what I would call the best dirt bike you can buy off Amazon for $1,000. There are some other brands out there. They really just don't hold up as well as this Apollo does. I've had this one for a year. It's lasted me pretty gosh darn good and I'm pretty happy with it. And if you guys wanna see some riding videos, you guys can go ahead, click up here. There's a whole plethora of riding videos. Make sure you guys click subscribe because we go riding nearly every single weekend on this channel. So there's a whole bunch of riding videos if you guys wanna see that and how this thing performs out on the trail. You guys can go over, head over to the channel, check this out because there is so much riding content on this bike. So if you guys have enjoyed this video, make sure you guys click like, leave a comment down below if you got any questions, click subscribe and the notification bell. And you guys should click the join membership button if you guys wanna come chat with me and look at all the dirt bike guides I have on the Apollo dirt bikes. So other than that, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.